definitely, I think there is going to be a revolution, a new revolution with artificial intelligence and data-driven approaches. and I think that there's no stopping that. You know, there will be technological evolution in that space. I think applied fields are already seeing that. You know, because there, you know, you can now easily run, easily perform experiments. There's so much data everywhere that you can take that data and train your models. Before you had to really work in look at the physics and develop a model and see how well it predicts experiments. Now you can just use that data to build your model. That's the idea. You're entirely skipping a step that used to take a lot of time and thought.
So that's why you look at the popular topic, popular mini symposium in the conference. You know, soft matter is very popular, robotics is very popular, right? Algorithm is very popular, machine learning is very popular, because to control the robotics, we need better machine learning algorithm to understand how to control the robot, right? Not only manipulation or locomotion, it can be more complicated, like the robot understand and response to our physical and the emotion cues, right? That is all mechanic-centered topics, and this topic evolving and increasing in a fast trend.
AI is, as you know, a very hot topic across all areas. Of course, it is dominated currently by the discussion of large language models, LLMs, but the real, which is of course very important, But it seems to me that there could be collateral developments in physical sciences. That's where I am. So I'm trying to myself to introduce a lot of tools from computer science into physical AI. And physical AI you can define as the area where the bytes meet the atoms. So it could, physical AI could be designing new materials, smart materials, designing new drugs. In silico trials, which will eliminate a lot of cost. So this, the impact will be on applications, how you can bring in any developments in standard AI, but looking forward to general AI and intelligence, machine intelligence, not just machine learning, but machine intelligence.
Should young scientists be concerned that they won't be able to get jobs?
No, I think there will be different jobs. I will cut down some of the repetitive part, but I think there will be new jobs. I am actually very optimistic about it, that there will be more new jobs.
More and more intelligent robotics equipped with a different type of sensors, actuators, and even CPU, those circuits with artificial intelligence to help the robotics to make decisions. That's one of the examples that we envision in the future.
But how much will that make a difference to some of these fundamental areas of science? You know, engineering, definitely, I think there is going to be a revolution. Fundamental sciences, where we already have existing models, how data science and machine learning methods will be useful there is time will tell.